Fellow Malaysians, the Sabah election on 26th of September is not just about Sabahans. It is about the future of Malaysia. There are two major implications on national politics. First, if Sabahan rejects Perikatan Barisan Nasional UMNO and vote for Warisan Plus, it will send a very strong message, an overwhelming message to all the Kataks that no one should try to disrupt our democracy by using money, by trying to usurp any democratically elected governments. But the second point is more important. If Warisan Plus can win an overwhelming majority, with a convincing majority, I'm quite sure Tan Sri Muhyiddin Yassin would not call a national election. For any party at the federal level to call a snap poll, he would have to have the confidence of winning at least 130 to 135 seats in the parliament. Otherwise, there's no point to call. Much as there are people who say that Perikatan or UMNO or PAS could win a strong victory in the peninsula, I would say that Pakatan Harapan Plus will at least win 80 seats in the peninsula out of 165. In the 2008 election, the opposition won 80 parliamentary seats in peninsula. In the 2013 election, Pakatan Rakyat won 80 constituencies in the peninsula out of 165. And in the 2018 election, Pakatan Harapan won 98 constituencies on election night in the peninsula. Assuming that Pakatan could win 80 seats in the peninsula, and with some swing to Warisan Plus, we could win up to 20 parliamentary seats in Sabah. That will bring to about 100 seats, and that hasn't counted seats from Sarawak. In the 2018 election, our side of the politics won 14 seats in Sabah and 10 seats in Sarawak. That brought to 122 on election night. My point is, as long as there is a major victory in Sabah, that will mean that even without Sarawak, the opposition will have about 100 seats, and anyone who calls a snap election now is asking for trouble for himself. That is the significance of the Sabah election on 26th of September.